Well, we're in a 21st century setting, Southampton St Mary's Stadium, and Alan Smith has joined me, Martin Tyler, to describe the action for you here. Southampton in action today against Stoke City. A very strong defence, the best defence in the division, against a side that just can't find the back of the opponents. They're the lowest scoring side that we have in this company. They'll find it hard to get goals, I think, against a defence as strong as this one.
Yeah, you would fancy them, as long as they don't take the foot off the gas. I can't see the visitors scoring here.
Looking at the lineup, he's got all the components in place, hasn't he, the manager, for the pressing style of play that's been a feature of his team.
Yeah, and many an opponent has found it difficult to cope with. If your touch isn't spot on against this aggressive type of closing down, you're going to lose it in dangerous areas.
Big reshuffle for Stoke today. Lee Grant starts today in place of Jack Butland, who's not looked that confident lately. Glenn Johnson replaces Matija Nastasic, who's been out of sorts lately. Charlie Adam comes in for Janelle Imbula, who's disappointed in matches recently. In attack, Peter Crouch starts, replacing Divock Origi, whose form has been poor lately.
Thank you for attending St Mary's Stadium. Enjoy the match.
Referee starts the match. And the kickoff. Well, he saw the guy he could switch the play to and came up with the pass as well. Excellent. They've got numbers in this attack and it looks dangerous. Whipped in from the wide area. That is one of the great saves.
Had no right to stop that. Had no right to get a hand on it. What a stop.
Played in by Ward-Prowse. Oh, that's great work by the goalkeeper. Darren Fletcher. Oh, he's cut that out well, well read. It's looking good, this move. He went in well. And here's Crouch. Charlie Adam. No booking from the referee, just a free kick. James Ward-Prowse. Cordoba. Charlie Adam. Jeff Cameron. And here they are on the attack. Made the challenge well. Manager here has had an attractive offer to manage at international level, but not attractive enough for him, it seems. Got to be. Well, he's put it away brilliantly. That kind of chance has come to him so early in the game, but I have to say, he reacted perfectly. Really sharp right from the off, and they've taken the lead here. Replay confirming for us here that the goalkeeper did get a touch, but not strong enough to keep the ball out of his net.
Well, he is his own harshest critic, this lad, and he'll blame himself for that, I think, having got a touch. Well, it's been tight before that goal, but now the manager, he's so pleased because I reckon he feels his team can go on and win this.
Southampton in front.
Goal for Southampton. Number 10.
Sweeney.
Charlie Austin.
And it's Fletcher. Darren Fletcher. Played forward. A bit of menace in this attack. It's good work between these two. Real chance. He's got there, but got the ball away as well. Christian Pulisic. Dusan Tadic. Wasteful pass, unforced error, really. On the attack here. Always risky, sliding in like that, particularly in the penalty area, but he got away with it this time. Challenges for the ball. Jeff Cameron. Ramadan Sobhi.
Saw the goal and went for it.
Good stop by the goalkeeper. Stokes corner. Here comes the corner. Surely the equaliser, and he's put it away. Slow and steady wins the race. It certainly gives the goal here. Explosive shooting from Stoke City.
Well, defensively, you could pick holes in it, but the way he attacked it, what a clinical finish.
Well, let's take another look at the goal. It is level. Both sides have scored here now.
Stoke City goal, number 25.
Pulisic.
Peter Crouch.
This could lead to a chance. It's good attacking play. Jeremy Pierre.
And shoots!
Good block. Well, they've got a corner out of that. A bit lucky, it was deflected. James Ward-Prowse with the corner. How did he save that?
He's one of the best in the business from those kind of situations. Absolutely brilliant.
I'm just worried about the rain only, in that it's impairing a bit our visibility of the proceedings out there on the pitch.
Yeah, we're nice and dry up here, but unlike the players, who will be pretty wet after 5 minutes.
He's on the move all the time and makes... And here's the shot! It's gone! And they've gone into the lead! And undoubtedly deserved. They have been by far the superior side, and they really imposed their will on the opposition. Too good, really, for the defending. And the shot in the end, far too good for the goalkeeper.
He's not the easiest of managers to work for, I know that, but these players are doing what he demanded beforehand now.
Stoke City, trail here then.
Goal for Southampton.
Adam.
Number 16, James Ward-Prowse.
Going forward well.
Well, if you look at the coaching manual, you don't defend like that. He's got caught too square to his man there, Paul.
Well, he was in the right place at the right time to cut it out.
Here's Edwards. Good strong tackle. And that will be a throw. It's Ward-Prowse. Cordoba. Peter Crouch. Did well, stuck out a foot and cut off the pass. They've got numbers in this attack, and it looks dangerous. Jeff Cameron. guiding the pass through. In with a chance, an excellent chance, more than matched by the goalkeeper, who's diffused the situation.
Oh, great agility, great reflexes there, and denying the opposition any knockdowns as well.
Corner swung in.
Well, that's good defending. Darren Fletcher. Charlie Adam. Cordoba. And it's Fletcher. Coming on strong. And looking to play their way through now. Whipped in from the wide area. Tries to punch it away. Darren Fletcher. He's got the ball back. Well, the defender. Now Austin. A lot can happen in 4 minutes. That's what we've got of added time. Oh, he's through. Cross driven in low, cleared away by the defender. Charlie Adam. I think he saw the look from the other player and saw where the pass was going and read it. Peter Crouch. Getting forward well as a team now. Cameron. Peter Crouch. Well, if you keep going in to that sort of area, the ball will drop for you, and it dropped perfectly for him.
I think that's a lesson to anybody enduring a goal drought. Keep getting into the positions in the 18-yard, in the 6-yard box, and you will score.
Yeah, the referee's signalling for the substitution to take place now. He's going to go off, and he's going to go off to a huge ovation.
Yeah, and look at him, he's lapping it up, and why wouldn't he? He's putting an awful lot of effort here, quality.
So it's 2-2 now. Very entertaining first half here, and we reach the break at 2-2. Half-time, and the team that were concerned about scoring have done that and really put themselves in the contest.
Yeah, well, maybe it's one of those games that they take a draw out of. Might just nick a win if they can find something.
They've got numbers in this attack. This could be a problem for the referee in the second half because the rain is still lashing down. Neatly intercepted. There's good progress with this attack. Cleared away, well away from goal. Ramadan Sobhi. Darren Fletcher. Got the ball and they're going at the opposition with speed. Fletcher on the move and able to cut out the pass. Darren Fletcher. Ramadan Sobhi. Trying a bit too hard, trying to force the pass, and it went straight to an opponent. Bit of space for him. Now out on the wing. Getting the shot go! Another decent try, but we're still level in this match. And the manager deciding to go for it and bring on a new player. Adam. Played to Glenn Johnson. And Johnson. Coming up for you on EA Sports, don't forget, don't miss this, the coverage of the Premier League fixture for Southampton. They'll be facing Norwich City away from home.
Yeah, I've heard a lot of supporters get excited about it, and I am as well.
It's looking good, this move. The break is definitely on.
Going to try his luck. Goalkeeper can only parry it out. Incisive pass. He's in. And the goalkeeper got across to it.
Now he's a bit disappointed. He's going to be taken off here. And the manager may be saving him for another day, but also allowing him to get the full appreciation from the fans.
Well, he was enjoying it. I don't think he wanted to come off, but he's a key part of this team. He's got to be protected.
Put the corner in the middle. And they get it away. Shot on! Shot blocked here. Now, here is a...
It's a save with a degree of comfort, Alan.
Yeah, that was never going to finish up a goal.
On the front foot now, they've got a corner, hoping for the goal that will put them in the lead.
Shots on here.
Christian Pulisic. Guerrero.
The shot's on. Good block.
It's an excellent cross. Ramadan Sobhi. Well, they've got the ball back now in the middle of the field.
Oh, he's cut that out well, well read.
Pressed high here.
Come away with the ball cleanly. Great tackle.
On to Stoke City's next game, Alan. Any thoughts?
They're playing Watford in their next match. And the two managers have summed it up. I think there's not going to be much between them.
Moving forward with some danger to the opposition now they're here.
Cool.
Piece of interplay between the two. Good, strong tackle.
Trying to stretch the opposition, using the wider areas here. Must score! Got in the way.
He's taken a touch there off the defender. It will be a corner. I think the manager's decided he wants to let the player have a great individual reception, which he wouldn't get at the final whistle. He's getting an ovation now as the substitution is made.
Yeah, and well-deserved too. A strong contender for man of the match.
Adam took that corner, and here's the shot.
He's on the move all the time and makes lots of these interceptions.
Hit in hard and low. The shot's hit the post, and there it is, the goal, and it's put them into the lead.
Always gets involved, this manager. Loves to hug his players after a goal. Great scenes.
The service came from wide, and it created the chance that was taken.
They know what they're getting with their wide players in this team, and you can always make your runs with a lot of assurance.
Stoke City have the lead.
Stoke City goal. Number 22, Sheldon Shaqiri.
Now this looks promising. Got the tackle in. Chance to go at the opposition with pace.
neatly intercepted.
Well, today the Saints haven't been marching in, have they? But they could still find something later in the game to make it a happier day.
Well, the fans, they paid the money and they're entitled to feel a little...
Saw the goal and went for it. Deflected and in.
Well, it's a bit unlucky from the defender's point of view, but the lad took a chance with the shot.
One more look at what happened earlier. Could the defender have done anything different, Alan?
Well, maybe he's half turned away, and that didn't help. If he'd have closed it down a bit more bravely, it might have been better.
But you can't blame him. The manager is delighted with the character his team has shown to get back into this game.
Two teams brilliantly matched in this contest. It's level again.
Number 10, Charlie.
Here's Edwards. Cameron. Edwards. Oh, that interception there might just have saved his side. To Johnson. Darren Fletcher. Johnson. It goes out wide again. It's a foul by the Southampton player. It's going to be a card. It's going to be a yellow card.
Well, that's the least surprising thing I've seen out there today so far.
Was that just a case of mistiming the tackle?
Didn't look comfortable going into it, and it was a definite foul.
Quickly when they get possession. The position slow to get back, so possibilities still on the counter-attack.
For today's man of the match, number 10, Charlie Austin.
And that's handball, referee's seen it. Minutes to be added on.
Cleared away, well away from goal.
Shaqiri. He's got his shot off now. It's a fine stop at full stretch from the keeper to turn that aside. It's a corner kick, and that means a chance. Charlie Adam with the corner. Gonna try his luck. He could have been the hero here. That was a genuine chance to put this game to bed.
I think the situation got the better of him in there, and he just snatched at it, lost his composure.
Game finished, and it's finished level. All credit to everyone involved here. The game could have been called off, really. They played it, and aren't we glad they did?
Yeah, the weather was poor, but the pitch was good, and the play was even better.
Well, given their inability to score, Alan, it's very important that they defend well, and the visitors have done just that to get the draw.
Yeah, I mean, admirable stuff. I think I won't remember this game for too long, though.